In the previous lessons, we've discussed themes in the WordPress customizer. In this lesson, we'll talk about another aspect of customizing your site, widgets. A WordPress widget is a simple pre-built block you can add to your site that serves a specific function. Okay, that sounds really abstract. Let's just take a look at some widgets. Like the search bar widget. If you add the search bar widget to your sidebar, your visitors will be able to search the pages on your site. That's great, right? And it's really, really simple to add, which you'll see in the upcoming screencast. That's the magic of widgets. Your site gets a little something special without too much hassle. Even if you're not very technical and you don't know how to code, you can add lots of functionality to your site simply by adding widgets. And you have tons of widgets that do all kinds of different things that may be convenient for your site. Like showing a list of your most recent posts, or an image, or an audio player, much more. With these widgets, you can give your site the look and feel you prefer and make your website more suitable to the content you want to offer. We'll go into several types of widgets in a bit, but let's focus on the practical applications first. So where can you place these widgets on your site? Well, you can't just randomly put widgets anywhere. Widgets can only be put into so-called widget areas. These areas are defined by your theme and are usually located in the sidebar and the footer of your site, which also means that widgets often appear site-wide, so across several pages. However, some themes don't include any widget areas, so if you want to use widgets, it's wise to check this when selecting a theme. Now, onto the types of widgets that are available to you. WordPress offers a selection of useful widgets by default. Let's take a look at the most used ones in detail. First of all, the text widget. This is the most versatile default widget, because it allows you to add nearly anything to one of your site's widget areas. This could be a simple text, a collection of links, or a media file. Second, there's the search widget. This widget adds a fully functional search bar to your site, which helps your visitors to easily find what they're looking for on your site. Third, there's a recent post widget. And as the name already implies, this widget adds a list of your most recent posts to your site, so your visitors will be encouraged to read more of your latest content. Other default widgets are, for example, the recent comments widget, the archives widget, the categories widget, the calendar widget, and the gallery widget. We'll go into these widgets in more detail in the reading materials. Most of these widgets allow you to enter a title and tweak a few basic settings. When adding a widget, we recommend you to look through these options and make sure they match your needs. In a screencast in this lesson, we'll show you how you can add a widget to your site and set the options. In addition to the default widgets, there are non-default third-party widgets as well, created by the WordPress community. These widgets allow you to personalize your site even more. Firstly, some themes offer additional widgets beside the default ones. For example, a theme dedicated to selling products in an online store will most likely offer a most popular products widget that you can place on your site. Secondly, lots of plugins add widgets that help you enhance your site. There are a number of plugins that add a new widget or a bundle of widgets to your dashboard. For example, there's a plugin that allows you to add social media sharing buttons and icons as a widget on your site. We'll go into the plugins, where to find them, and how to install them in the next lesson in this module.